Imigisha tugiye kuvugaho ni imigisha ku ruhande rurebana n'ubutunzi n'amafaranga.
The blessing we are going to talk about is the blessing of wealth and money.
Kuko ushobora no kugira n'imigisha y'abana.
Because you might also have the blessing of children.
N'imigisha y'ubuzima bwiza.
The blessing of a good health.
Ibyo byose ntabwo twabivuga mu mwanya umwe.
We can't talk about all that in just one lesson.
Ushobora kugira umugisha w'inshuti.
You can have the blessing of friends.
Ibyo rero ntabwo twabivuga byose nona.
So we can't exhaust it all in one session.
Amen.
Amen.
Ikintu kirebana n'amafaranga ni ikintu pratique.
Issues pertaining to money, it's something practical.
Ushobora kuvuga uti nzajya mu ijuru ariko sinzi igihe nzagirayo, sinzi n'ukuntu nzajyayo, ariko ibyo ntabwo ari big issue, igikuru ni uko uzajyayo.
You might say that I'm going to heaven, we don't know when you're going to heaven or how, but the most important is that you're going there to heaven.
Ariko ku mafaranga ntago wavuga ibyo.
But about money you can say that.
Ntago wavuga ngo nyafite ntayafite ngo nta kibazo ngo igikuru nuko ndiho. No.
You might not say whether I have money or I don't have money, the most important is that I'm alive. No.
Kubera ko ari ikibazo pratique.
Because it's something practical.
Ni ikibazo buri wese ahura nacyo.
It's something everyone faces.
Akaba ni naryo rimwe mu masomo ku giti cyanjye nabonye agoye kuyigishwa n'Imana.
And it's one of the difficult lessons I have seen, something we learned from God, it's one of the most difficult lessons.
Kubera ko ibintu biba biri muri Bibiliya.
Because these things are in the Bible.
Ariko kubyigishwa n'Imana narwo ni urundi rugendo.
But it's another journey learning it from God, being taught by God on that subject.
Iyo urebye muri Bibiliya n'abigishwa byarabagoye kubyiga.
You know, when you look in the Bible, even the disciples, it was difficult for them to learn that.
Rimwe Yesu yarababwiye ngo nibagaburira abantu 5,000.
There is a time Jesus told them to feed 5,000 people.
Bari mu butayu.
They were in the wilderness.
Urumva icyo kigeragezo.
You see that kind of trial?
Nuko dukeya bari bafite Imana iduha umugisha, mugabo babyikuramo abantu bararya baranasagura.
And the little they had, God multiplied it and they were able to have even excess.
Hashize igihe gito.
And sometime later,
bahura n'undi n'ikindi kibazo.
They faced another problem.
Noneho bagomba kugaburira 4,000.
Now they had to feed 4,000 people.
Urumva byo bari nabake ugereranyije n'5,000.
You know, 4,000 are fewer than 5,000.
Uziko reaction yabo yabaye nk'uko byagenze mbere.
You know that their reaction was similar to the previous one.
N'undi baravuze ngo ya dufite amadenariyo makeya cyangwa amadolari make, rero babwire batahe ntago twabagaburira.
He said we do not have enough money, so just tell them to go back home because we can't have enough to feed them.
Ubwo isomo ntago bari barifashe.
That means that they had not gotten that lesson properly.
Niba uko wagiraga reaction ku mafaranga mu myaka 10 ishize ariko n'ubuki reactinga, ubwo isomo nturarifata.
If you're still reacting the same way towards money issues the way you did 10 years ago, it means that you haven't learned your lesson yet.
Yanuko Yesu yongera gukora igitangaza.
And Jesus did another miracle again.
Duke bari bafite Imana Yesu aradutura, nuko abantu barajya barahaga barasagura.
And the little they had, Jesus multiplied it and people ate and they were full and they even had excess.
Hashize igihe gito.
Sometime later,
Yesu bari mu bwato bagenda.
Jesus, while they were on the way in a boat,
bafite umugati umwe gusa.
They had only one bread.
Yesu arababwira ati mwirinde umusemburo w'abafarisayo.
Jesus told them, be careful about the yeast of Pharisees.
Bari bafite umugati umwe ari 12 gusa.
They had one loaf of bread and there were 12 of them.
Kandi imigati ine yari yarahagije 5,000.
And 4 pieces of bread had satisfied 5,000 people.
N'ubundi reaction yabaye nk'uko bari yagitinze mbere cya gihe.
And you know, they had the same reaction as they had before.
Ubuse koko turirinda gute imisembura y'abafarisayo dufite umugati umwe kandi twambutse tugiye gushaka imigati ngo dukore imigati.
They said, how are we going to keep from the yeast of Pharisees yet we have only one bread and we are crossing to go and get more bread?
Nuko barahangayika.
And they were worried, anxious.
Yesu aratangara.
And Jesus was surprised.
You
know, you need to amaze Jesus because of your belief, not your unbelief. Because the Bible mentions the two. The Bible says that Jesus went to Nazareth and he was amazed, he was surprised by their unbelief.
But
there is a soldier who told him, you don't have to come to my house, just say a word because I'm also a soldier and when I say one word, my subordinates, they are going to do that. And Jesus was so surprised and amazed at his faith. Now, how do you amaze Jesus? By your faith or by your unbelief? Let us learn. So he was so amazed at their unbelief.
He said,
you were there when I fed the 5,000, you were there when I fed the 4,000. Now you're thinking about this yeast, why it's not what I was mentioning. Actually, he was referring to teachings of the Pharisees, not about bread. So as you can see, the problem of eating and having bread, it was something that had traumatized them somehow. You know, something that traumatized you, even if it's not what they are talking about, that's what you hear. They had not got the lesson properly. And Jesus had them repeat.
Saying.
And one day when he sent them to preach the gospel, he told them, do not take spare shoes and clothes. And do not take any single coin in your pocket. Just go. And he knew that they might go around begging, and he said, on the way, do not greet anyone. And then after that, he asked them, when I sent you, did you lack anything? They said, we didn't lack anything.
Amen.
Amen.
Those ones,
they continued the work of God after Jesus had gone to heaven. And they did that work in a good way. And they have left that work to us. Paul has passed on and we're the ones who are alive. You know, Ephesus is now a city of Muslims. There is no more Christianity there. It's only what they can hear from Omega. Even Jerusalem is no longer the center of the world, the Christian world. Actually, the place where Christianity is growing so much is in Africa.
Now, you're
going to face the problem of money, or you have already faced it. Because there is no way you can preach the gospel if you don't have the means. And the problem, they told you that it is a sin to steal. And yet they told you that you have to go. Now, the question that remains is, are you going to believe that there is a sponsor who is going to sponsor you, or you're going to get it from God?
Or you still believe that
there will be sponsors there to address your needs of money, or is Jesus who is going to do that?
Let me tell you. Mwe muri benshi biragaragara ko umuntu yaba supporting ari umugiraneza ariko ntazaza gukemura ikibazo cy'ibigori na gahungi wawe.
You know, even a sponsor, if he comes, he can support the church like this because it's apparent we are many, but he's not going to come and address the need of food in your home.
Uzajuza hano ufashwe.
You come here, you'll be supported.
Ube mu kirori.
And you'll be there in a party.
Ariko nugera iwawe urya gahunga kadafite sauce.
But when you go home, you eat maize pap without sauce.
Nuko wiyakire.
And then you accept that situation.
Ibyo ntabwo bibuza umujyama kugenda atikoraho rwose.
Because that is no issue for a young man.
Ariko ikibazo kizaba gihari.
But the problem will still be there.
Ubwo rero nakubwiraga ngo.
So I will tell you.
Hari ibibazo udashobora ku avoiding.
There are some problems that you can never avoid.
Ibyiza rero ni ukubifacing.
So the best way is to face those problems.
Amahirwe dufite nuko bibiri bivugaho byose.
The beauty is that the Bible mentions everything.
Amen.
Amen.
No, no, bamwe twahishuriye ko nabyo Yesu yabipfiriye.
And some of us, we have understood that Jesus, he died for many things, including those. So myself, I have faced such problems. Jesus told Nicodemus, we speak about what you know and what we have seen. You know, ministry is difficult, serving God is difficult. You know, coming and singing things that you don't believe in is so difficult.
And you say
you're so good, Jesus, I exalt you, yet in your heart you feel like killing him, you feel like he's useless to you. And teaching is the same. You need to teach things that you know and that you have seen, experienced. Because when you teach things that you haven't seen, you haven't experienced, it's not powerful among those who listen to what you're teaching. Actually, it closes your mouth, it shuts your mouth, and it puts you aside from the place.
1992
is a year I will never forget in my spiritual history. For us who were born in the north, you know that the war of liberation had started. I had had the blessing of children because I had two children in the same year. So a year is 12 months and a child can be born in 9 months, so it's possible to have two in a year. But when those are times of war and you're only a teacher, it's not easy. So I had to come and buy gigos in Kigali.
Kandi udufaranga dukibwo naguraga imwe gusa.
And because I didn't have enough means, I would only buy one.
Na igezayo ubwo kandi byandikagaho ngo ukoreshe uko byanditse ku gikopo ntushyiremo amazi menshi ngo uyitubure.
And they will tell you to use it according to the instructions. There is a certain amount of liquid of water you have to put, not more, to make it. So that was stressful for me. And at that time, I was serving God even though I was not yet a pastor. But I knew Jesus was the only one who called those who are weary and tired. He said, all of you who are weary and tired, come to me. Do you know anyone else? So I was tired. Imagine, I had Jesus and I was the one supposed to preach about him in those hills I was living in. I was supposed to talk good things about him. Because you know that everyone is tired, you just keep that word and take it everywhere.
And you preach
about it so many times. And yet you feel in your heart like you want to give up. So when things are like that, God is telling you that you need the light. Amen.
Ufite ijambo ridafite umucyo.
You have a word, but that word doesn't have the light.
Cyangwa mu mvugo mumenyereye ubufite itara ridafite amavuta.
Or in the language you're used to, you have a lamp, but it doesn't have oil.
Urumva rero iyo bahamagaye bafite amatara uragenda.
So when they call those who have lamps, you go.
Ariko iyo bahamagaye abacana amatara uvamo.
But when they call those who light their lamps, you step aside. That's why we need to get the revelation of scriptures.
Ukahabwa ukigishwa n'Imana.
And learn from God, be taught by God.
Cyo gihe rero natangiye gusoma Bibiliya.
So at that time I started reading the Bible.
Ariko ntago nayisomye mpereye ruhande.
But I didn't read it from cover to cover.
Ahubwo narebaga gusa havuga amafaranga.
I only look at those scriptures that talk about money.
Kubera ko Bibiliya nari nyimenyereye, nari maze imyaka 10 nkijijwe nkorera Imana, nari nyimenyereye kabisa.
Because I was so used to the Bible, I had been saved for 10 years, I was serving God, so I knew about the Bible.
Ahavuga amafaranga n'ahatavuga amafaranga nari maze.
And I knew those passages of scriptures that talk about money and those that don't.
Ariko noneho nibwo nari nangiye kuyisoma nzi icyo nshaka.
But then that's when I had started reading the Bible purposely.
Nibwo nabonye ko Bibiliya itangizwa n'izahabu ikarangizwa n'izahabu.
That's when I saw that the Bible starts with gold and ends with gold.
Ngo muri Edeni harimo imigezi ngo kandi irimo amazahabu meza.
The Bible said that in the Garden of Eden there were rivers and in those rivers there were gold, precious gold, pure gold.
Noneho kandi mu byahishuwe ngo iyo mihanda y'iyo muri Yerusalemu nshya ni amazahabu.
And in the book of Revelation the Bible says that the streets in the New Jerusalem they are paved in gold.
Ngo nagize ikibazo ndavuga se muri Edeni havuyeho Yerusalemu nshya ntiharaza izahabu twayikurashe.
And then now my question was, Eden is no longer there and the New Jerusalem is not yet coming, where are we going to get the gold? And then I was blessed enough to read that everything was in Jesus Christ, placed in Jesus Christ. At that time I didn't clap because it was not edifying for me. You know, you don't clap when you're learning, you only clap when after you have graduated. Now you have to sit and you let Jesus teach you.
Amen.
Amen. So one of the things I learned that time, let us share it briefly. But I'm still learning. There are some lifelong lessons that you have to learn. You might say I've been married for 15 years, so I have something I can help others with the marriage I have learned. But even these parents who are leading you, they are still learning about marriage. This beautiful woman is still learning to give care to this old man. So there are lifelong lessons that never ends. So let us learn together. Psalm 24 verse 1. It said the earth is the Lord's, and everything in it, its fullness, belongs to the Lord. And everyone who lives in the world belongs to the Lord. That is enough to show you how rich our Father in heaven is. And when you read the Bible and you see that God is love, you see that a loving father is pleased to give his children the good things.
No, yaradutumye ngo tuyikorere.
And now he has sent us to serve him. When you tell a mason to build a house like this, you give him money to buy all the materials that are needed. So immediately I have understood that while we are serving God according to his plan, we find his blessing there. That's when I took the decision that for me to be blessed, I don't need to leave teaching.
Work.
I think I'll die still being a teacher, and if you tell me other things, it's not going to pass. And I don't need to go look for that blessing in Norway and Australia, it will find me here.
Rero nabonye nyuma ko ahantu hose Imana yakoresheje abantu yagiye ibaha umugisha.
And I have seen that everywhere God used people serving him, he has blessed those people.
Ubutumwa bwageze Burayi babukwiza hose Imana yabahaye umugisha.
The gospel came to Europe and they spread it to the whole world and God blessed them.
Ubutumwa bwageze muri Amerika babukwiza hose Imana yabahaye umugisha.
The gospel went to the US and they spread it worldwide and God blessed them.
Aho ubutumwa bwageraga barabukwizaga.
So wherever the gospel will go to, they will spread it.
None ubyutse bugeze muri Afrika.
And now the revival has come to Africa.
Mu bihugu byinshi siho wasanga amacaceza ameze gutya.
It's not in so many countries you can find churches like this.
Yuzuye abantu kandi bose ari urubyiruko, abenshi ari urubyiruko.
Full of people and many of them being young.
Africa ifite umugisha.
Africa is blessed.
Ariko uwo mugisha ugendanye n'inshingano.
But that blessing goes with responsibility.
Iyo uhawe ubutumwa bwiza uba ufite inshingano yo kubujyana handi.
When you receive the gospel, you have the responsibility to spread it, to take it
in other places.
So we have to do that. When you receive the gospel and you don't take it to places where it's needed, you won't be blessed. Actually, you get a curse. So for us to be blessed by God, we need to love God and obey him. Not just because we want to go to heaven.
Matthew chapter
19 from verse 16, they talk about the young rich man.
He had
so much money.
Kandi yashakaga no kujya mu ijuru.
And he wanted to go to heaven.
Nuko aza kubaza Yesu icyo yakora.
Now he came to ask Jesus what he could do.
Yesu aramubwira ngo uzatunganye amategeko.
Jesus told him to keep the commandment.
Yamubwiye atandatu.
He told him six about.
Kutiba, kutica, kudasambana, kutabeshya.
Shall not commit adultery, not steal, not bear false witness. Honor your parents and love your neighbor.
Umusore yahise yiterera hejuru aravuga ati sawa, guhera mu bwana ibyo nari narabyitondeye ngo nzajye mu ijuru.
And the young man, he was so excited, he said, from my youth I have kept those so that I can have eternal life.
Ariko niba warasomye Bibiliya wabonye ko Yesu atatangiriye ku itegeko rya mbere.
But if you read the Bible properly, you saw that Jesus didn't start with the first commandment.
Itegeko rya mbere ntabwo rivuga ko.
The first commandment is not about not lying and stealing. It is loving God with your whole heart and strength and soul. Jesus left that intentionally. He knew that that young man doesn't love God with his whole heart and whole strength.
One
of the things that come out of your strength is your wealth, because it is a result, it is a product of your strength. So loving God with all your strength is also loving him with everything you own, your money. So it's not about the tenth and offerings. It is what is called building the kingdom of God. It's wider. You know, building the kingdom of God goes way beyond that, just giving one tenth and offerings. And you know the story, that young man went back sad because he loved his wealth.
Yakundaga amafaranga ye, biriya byo kutiba, kudasambana, kutabeshya, byari byo kusibanganya ibimenyetso ko adakunda Imana.
He loved his money and everything he was doing was a cover up just to hide the fact that he doesn't love God.
Ushobora kuba umwana mwiza.
You might be a good person. You come to church. You offer and you even partake on the Holy Communion they just mentioned.
And
they know that you're someone of integrity, you don't steal, you don't lie, and you even pray at home. And even in your home, no one consumes alcohol. That is no guarantee of going to heaven. It might even be a cover-up of the signs that you don't love God.
Itegeko rya mbere rivuga ko twegurira Imana umutima wacu wose.
The first commandment says that we have to give God our whole heart.
Tugayiha ibyacu byose.
And everything we own.
Sibye ko ari twebwe ibibitsa.
But on the other hand, he gives it to us as stewards for us to keep it.
Ubigisonga cy'iby'Imana.
You become a steward of the things of God.
Noneho ukabicunga nk'ubicungira Imana.
And you manage it as if you're managing it for God.
Imana ikajya ibyongera.
And God will increase that.
Ikajya ibikoresha mu bwami bwayo.
And he will use it for his kingdom.
Noneho we n'Imana mukaba muri partnership.
And you and God are in a partnership.
Noneho business z'Imana zigatera imbere.
And God's business will prosper. That's the reason why you're here. That's why when we read in Proverbs chapter 10 verse 22, we see two types of blessings or of riches.
Uwo murongo uravuga ngo umugisha w'iteka atanga uzana ubukire kandi nta mubabaro yongeraho.
The Bible says the blessing of the Lord makes one rich and he adds no sorrow with it.
Hariho rero ubutunzi buherekejwe n'imibabaro n'ubutunzi budaherekejwe n'imibabaro.
So that means that there is wealth that is accompanied, or riches that is accompanied by sorrow, and the riches that is not accompanied by sorrow.
Reka nkubwire ikintu cyose uteguriye Imana kizaguteza agahinda.
Let me tell you, everything you have not surrendered fully to God is going to cause you sorrow and trouble.
Ibyo ni ukuri.
That is the truth.
Kizakuzanira uburushyi.
It's going to cause you hardships.
Kandi wibuke ko Yesu atifuza rwose ko hariho n'umwe ubindushyi muri twe.
And remember that Jesus doesn't want any of us to live with hardships.
Kuko ubutunzi uteguriye Imana buzaba ikigirwamana kuri wowe.
Because the riches and wealth that you haven't surrendered to God is going to become an idol in your life.
Ntuzabukoresha mu kwagura ubwami bw'Imana.
You're not going to use it to expand the kingdom of God.
No, indicator ni ikintu kinini cy'ikimenyetso.
Now, the biggest indicator is that you will never be at rest in your heart, yet you have that wealth. Imagine that the unrest you had in your heart when you are still poor, you still have that unrest while you're rich.
Ubwo rero ugikennye Satani yarakuhumye amaso abyitirira ubukene.
Now, when you were still poor, the devil blinded you and he said that that unrest is because of the poverty you have. When you are still eating little, you think it is because of poverty. Now that you are rich, you can have enough to your satisfaction, you still have that unrest, and the devil has blinded you, telling you that it is the current thing now.
Tegereza ko ibigeze muri serire utangira kwigisha ijambo ngo Yesu Kristo ko yararejo n'uyu munsi niko ari niko azahora iteka ryose.
And now when you're in your cell, you start teaching Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Cyakora pastor yabivuze neza, iyo twigisha natwe tuba twiga.
But pastor said it right, when we are teaching we are also learning.
Iyo ubutunzi utabuhaye Imana uhora ufite impungenge ko buzatakara.
When you haven't surrendered your wealth and riches to God, you're always anxious that you're going to lose it. So that kind of wealth or riches is not a blessing. The blessing that doesn't go, the wealth that doesn't have sorrow, is the one that God gives. And that one contributes to building the kingdom of God. In Genesis chapter 26, verse 12, the Bible talks about a man called Isaac. He said he planted.
Yarahinze.
He planted.
Ntago yari umunebwe.
He wasn't a lazy person.
Ngo Imana imuha umugisha.
And God blessed him.
Ngo asarura inshuro ijana.
And he harvested 100-fold.
Ngo nuko aba umukire cyane.
And then he became very rich.
Baravugamo umugisha w'Imana.
There they talk about the blessing of God.
Kandi biravuga ko yari n'umukozi atari umunebwe.
And the Bible says that he was a worker, he wasn't lazy.
Agacara inyigisho ndende kuri ibyo mu isezerano rishya n'abakora into ba kabiri bice 8 n'ibice 9.
A long teaching about that is 2 Corinthians chapter 8 and 9.
Cyo cyamunane bavuga ko abantu ba Makedonia baha umugisha bagiri ubuntu.
The Bible says in chapter 8 that the people of Macedonia, they were blessed. They had the grace of God. Say, we make known to you the grace bestowed on the church of Macedonia. And they say how the people in Macedonia, they were not rich, but they gave of their wealth what they had. And they contributed to building the kingdom of God. I think you have already understood by now that the calling God is giving us will require financial means. Now listen to this.
Ayo mafaranga wowe ukora ibyo niwe Imana igomba kuyacishaho.
You who is busy doing that, you have to be the channel of that money.
Reka mafaranga yiritorera ave muri twe.
Let the money of this church come from our midst.
Noneho agucheho.
And let it come through you.
Uyakoresha ubwami bw'Imana.
And use it for the kingdom of God.
Ariko hagata uzabwishyura na school fees kandi waguze ni sauce.
And at the same time you'll be paying school fees and you have sauce for your food.
Twakuze inyama zitabonekera igi.
For us, when we were growing up, we could not afford to have meat every time we needed it. But now our children have grown, there is enough meat and sauce for them and on time.
Rero uhabwa umugisha ukuba ku bwami bw'Imana.
You know, as you build the kingdom of God, you're also supporting your family. And that's what the Bible teaches. Let God make you a channel of the blessing that is going to build his kingdom, do his work. Do you know, being in the worship team for 5 years and you can't even buy one microphone? And when the battery is down, you have to go to the pastor to ask for the battery of the microphone. I know it doesn't happen here, it happens in other places I went to. So the blessing God gives, it has to go through us. And as the kingdom of God expands, we have to play a role in that. If it requires money, that money can also come through me. Listen, Jesus has poured his mercy and it reached to you, and he has poured his spirit, that has reached to you too. Now, why when he poured the money, that money has been escaping from you? There is one explanation to that. And that is what I have learned since that year I've mentioned earlier. You believe that God gives his forgiveness? And you believe that Jesus has died so that we can get the Holy Spirit? But you don't believe that he has died so that you can also get the money? Now, that is what I have understood when I was doing that study from Genesis to Revelation, and that is in the times of old. I was asking myself this question: if all the blessings are hidden in Christ, how am I going to get those blessings? And I realized that Jesus died for that. Just like he died so that I can have the mercy, the forgiveness. Just like he died so that I can get the Holy Spirit. In Acts of Apostles, chapter 20, verse 33, Paul
said
that his hands have contributed to providing for his necessities together with those who were with him. Let me read that one.
Sinifuje ikintu cy'umuntu wese ari feza cyangwa izahabu cyangwa imyenda. Ubwanyu muzi yuko aya maboko yanjye ari yankenuraga ibyo nkennye n'abo twari turi kumwe. Nababereye icyitegererezo muri byose. Yuko ariko namwe mukwiriye gukora imirimo ngo mubone uko mufasha abadakomeye no kwibuka amagambo umwami Yesu yavuze ati gutanga guhesha umugisha kurusha guhabwa.
I have coveted no one's silver or gold or apparel. Yes, you yourselves know that these hands have provided for my necessities and for those who are with me. I have shown you in every way by laboring like this that you must support the weak. And remember the words of the Lord Jesus that he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive.
Guhera muri iyo myaka ya kera naretse kwizera Imana ngo impa amafaranga yo kugura ibiryo gusa. Natangiye nari nahise nsobanukirwa ko ngomba no kwizera Imana ngo mbone amafaranga yo kwagura ubwami bwayo.
From that time I have understood that I need to stop having faith only for my need, for my food. I have understood that I need to have faith for the provision of more than that, even to expand the kingdom of God.
Paul yaravuze ngo naritunze kandi ntunga nabo turi kumwe.
Paul said that I have provided for my needs and for those that were with me, and I have also given you an example of how you have to work. When you only care about your personal things, God will entrust you with little.
Wizirikana n'abandi muri kumwe n'ubwami bw'Imana Imana ikubitsa byinshi.
But when you care about more than you but also the people who are with you and the kingdom of God, God will entrust you with more.
Cyo nasobanukiwe icyo gihe.
So what I have understood that time,
icya mbere nuko ngomba gukira guhangarikira amafaranga.
The first is that I need to be set free from being anxious about money.
Ibyo bintu bizanwa no kugendana n'Imana.
And that comes from working with God.
Uti wabibonye ute?
And you can ask me, how did you find out?
Yesu avuga ngo ntimuhangarikira imyenda, ntimuhangarikira ibiryo.
When Jesus said, do not be anxious about food or clothes.
Yaravuze ngo nimurebe inyoni nimurebe n'indabyo.
He said, look at the birds and look at the flowers of the field.
Inyoni iguruka ntago ihangayika ngo ivuge ngo ndibwiture hasi.
When the bird is flying, it is not worried about falling down.
Kandi rurabyo ntiruhangayika ngo ndi mwiza cyangwa ndi mubi. Rurabyo ntago rugira mira indorerwamo.
And the flower doesn't have a mirror, so it's not worried about its appearance.
Ariko inyoni yapfuye wisanga mu mbuga yahanutse.
But when a bird has died, you find it in the field, it will have fallen there.
Nururabyo baruranduye ruruma rugatuba ubwiza.
And when a flower is uprooted, it will dry and it will no longer be beautiful.
Ubwo rero freedom y'inyoni n'ubwiza bw'ururabo biba mu buzima bwabyo.
So the freedom of the bird and the beauty of the flower is in their lives.
Ubuzima bwa Yesu muri wowe kubana na ukagendana nawe nibyo bizakura muri wowe guhangayika nushaka no guhangayika byange.
The life of Jesus in you is what is going to uproot that anxiety in you, and even when you try to worry, you won't worry.
Ubwo rero icya kabiri nuko uzi ko Yesu agukunda kandi abifite.
The second thing is knowing that Jesus loves you and he has what you need.
Isi niye.
The world is his,
it belongs to him,
and everything in it,
n'abayirimo,
and the people who are in it.
Ejo bundi nakoresheje ubukwe 2 weeks ago n'abandi bamwe muri mwe murabizi.
2 weeks ago we had a wedding in my family, and Eddie and others, they know about that.
Ubwo twakoresheje inama imwe y'ubukwe kandi nayo ntiyari ikenewe.
We only held one wedding meeting and it wasn't even very needed actually.
Twarasaguye amafaranga.
We had more money than we needed. We had excess.
Abakorana n'umukobwa baramubwiraga ngo shango ntago twari tuzi kuri uwo mubakire.
Those who worked with my daughter, they told her, we didn't know that you come from a rich family.
Ayo mafaranga ntabwo ari ayanjye. Abayirimo abari mu isi nabo witeka nimwe mwayatanze n'abandi.
That money is not from my pocket. Those who are in the world, they are his, so you are the ones who contributed to that.
Ikibazo ni kimwe.
Now the question is this.
Kubera iki uko kwizera tukugira gusa mu bukwe?
Why do we have that faith only for weddings?
Ababos urubyiruko mureba.
You see all these young people you see here?
Birashoboka ko adafite n'ibihumbi magana tano kuri konti.
It's possible that they might not even have 500,000 of their accounts.
Rekarongora raguha budget ya miliyoni esheshatu.
But when they are about to have a wedding, they will have give a budget of 6 million.
Akubwira shizamanga ku Imana izabikora kandi irabikora.
And they will tell you boldly that God will do it and he does it.
Kuberiki?
Why?
Yizeye.
He has believed.
None se twakwizeye no kubwami bw'Imana n'ahandi ho.
Now, why don't we believe even for the kingdom of God and for other issues of life?
Ni wizeye Imana izabikora.
When you believe God will do it.
Uzarebe urubyiruko rwose iyo bageze mu gihe cy'ubukwe baba abanyamasengesho bakava hasi.
You know, all the youth, when it is time for their weddings, they will become intercessors. They will pray like never before.
Nta nubwo asengera aha kuko ntibyamufasha ajya ku musozi n'ahandi.
And they won't even pray in this place. They will go to the mountains to pray there.
Abarokotse atubwo.
How come it's happening then?
None se wagumye gutya igihe cyose ugakorana n'Imana.
Now, why don't you keep working like that all times and work with God? It means the ball is on your side. Jesus, he has finished everything on the cross. Now I have understood that even though I might have a problem, Jesus will rescue me because he has everything I need.
Hashize imyaka nk'icumi nari mfite ibibazo by'amadeni aremereye cyane.
It's been 10 years ago, I had so many debts, and at some point I was losing that inner peace that I was used to. I was starting being anxious. And I told my wife, let us go pray 7 days. Let us pray for these debts. I want God to speak about it because I'm not living unless he says something. You know, sometimes you go to pray, it's like you're no longer breathing. And those prayers lasted for only 6 hours. I was telling God all my debts. I was telling him how I served him and how I deserved to be rescued by him. I was giving arguments like in a court.
Nagize umugisha udakunze kuboneka kenshi Imana yaramanutsira tuganiriza.
And I had a rare blessing. God came down and he started speaking to us.
N'ijambo rimwe gusa.
Just one word.
Yaratubaje ngo hari ubafunze.
He asked me, is anyone putting you in jail? And immediately I understood that no one would take me to jail, and I left and I went to work. Even up to today, no one has put me in jail, and that season was closed. It was over. Jesus has died so that you might have peace, and he has decided to be your guarantee. God doesn't have to put on your account all the money he has or even in your pocket. But when you need it, he provides. You have to get it. So I went on from that one Gigozi 92, and I had 6 more children. So I had 7 children. One of them passed away, so I have 6. That's what it means. 2 of them have graduated. Three of them are in university. They are doing their exams on time. It means we are paying. And the last born is in secondary school. I built a very nice and big house for my wife here in Kigali. And when you are building a house for your wife, be very careful about how you build the kitchen. When you have designed the kitchen nicely, then the rest is okay. And I didn't stop being a teacher.
Gorero umwarimu wavukiye mu misozi bikaba byaragenze gutyo nawe ubwo nta kibazo.
Now a teacher who was born in the mountains and things like that happened to him, you can understand that for you it also be well.
Paul yaravuze ngo nabaciri inzira.
Paul said, I made the way for you, I paved the way for you. But Paul is no longer there, he passed on, he's no longer helping you. And when you hear that he doesn't have a wife, you're no longer edified because you have a wife and you have children. But for me, I'm a teacher and I will die a teacher. And I will live in Kigali.
Yes, Hashim.
Praise be to Jesus.
Rero, Imana. Yesu yapfiriye n'amafaranga.
So Jesus, he also died for money.
Niba Imana ihari amafaranga arahari.
If God is there, money is there.
Bitangira kukumenya icyo Bibiliya ivuga.
It starts by knowing what the Bible says.
Aba bantu b'i Macedonia bari bafitiye umutwaro abantu b'i Yerusalemu.
The people in Macedonia, they had the burden for the people in Jerusalem.
Urumva umutwaro bari bafite?
You understand the burden they had?
Hagati ya Macedonia na Yerusalemu harimo ibihugu birindwi.
Between Macedonia and Jerusalem, there are 7 countries there.
Albania, Bosnia, Ugiriki, Bulgaria, Turkey, Syria, and Lebanon.
Albania, Syria, Lebanon, so many countries that he just mentioned. It's like the distance between here and South Africa. So they had a burden that was extended to that level. Now, how is your burden? Where does it extend to? There are some who don't even have a burden for this place they are sitting in. They will come and sit on this chair. They don't even know who bought that chair. You know, those who don't have a burden for where you're seated, you should be paying. At least it will cause you to have a burden. So they had a burden of people in Jerusalem. We need to have a burden that goes beyond to our place of living. I know that you have churches in the country. That is your burden. Don't say it's for the denomination. If it is, it does not concern you, then you don't love God. So coming here, giving your tithe is just trying to cover up. You don't love God. Because when you love God, the burden of God becomes your burden.
Iyo umusore akunda umukobwa atangira kumugurira amavuta kandi uwo musore atisiga ayo mavuta.
You know, when a young man loves a young lady, he starts buying lotion for her, and yet he doesn't use that lotion. It's just
agira umutwaro ku buryo anikopesha kugira ngo amusohokane.
He will have a burden so much that he can even take a date to take her out on a date.
Aba afite umutwaro wo kunezeza uwo mukobwa.
He has a burden to please that woman so that something might come out of it. I'm still surprised why the things we should be applying to the kingdom of God, it only works in our love stories and in the weddings. I tell you that Christian life is a marriage. In 2 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 2, when you read in the current version in
Kinyarwanda,
Paul said, I'm jealous for you with godly jealousy. For I have betrothed you to one husband that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ.
So
therefore, beloved, money is one of the things you have received in Christ. So the Bible talks so much about that teaching.
Ibice cyenda hamwe twasomye nizere ko mwahagumisha shakagozi abakorinto bakabira aka kagozi hari abatazi cyo aka kagozi
kabo. Just some who don't know what ugashiraho ugiye gusoma. Thread does you use it as a
Ibice separate. Cyenda umurongo wa 8 abakorinto bakabira.
2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8.
Kandi rero imana ishobora kubasazaho ubuntu bwose kugira ngo murusheho gukora ibyiza byose mufite ibibahagije muri byose nk'uko byanditswe ngo yaranyanyagije abakene gukiranuka kwe guhoraho iteka ryose.
And God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that always having all sufficiency in all things may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, he has dispersed abroad, he has given to the poor, his righteousness endures forever.
Aya ni amasezerano yahawe ababi Makedoniya kuko bari bafite umutwaro wo kwagura ubwami bw'Imana.
These are the promises that were given to the people in Macedonia because they had the burden to expand the kingdom of God.
Amasezerano yanditse arusha uburemere amasezerano atanditse.
You know, written promises, they are more valuable than promises that are not written.
Nkoze note nkavuga ngo nzaguha ibihumbi ijana bitandukanye no kukubwiza umunwa ngo nzaguha ibihumbi ijana.
If I make a note and write that I'm going to give you 100,000 francs, it's different with just telling you with words.
Niyo mpamvu hano bavuga ngo nkuko byanditswe ngo.
And that's why here they say as it is written.
Yababwiye ibyo Imana izavuga ababwira nuko byari byaranditswe kera.
He told them what God will do and he told them what was written before.
Imana itanga igishoro.
So God gives an investment.
Imana itanga igishoro.
God gives an investment.
Yesu ashimwe.
Praise be to Jesus.
Umurongo wa 10 aho ngaho.
On that first 10.
Ihu mubi by'imbuto n'imitsima yo kumugaburira.
He supplies seed to the sower and bread for food.
Niza baha ibongerera imbuto zanyu zo kubiba kandi gwiza imbuto zo gukiranuka kwanyu.
Will supply and multiply the seed you have sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. At that time, wealth was in cattle and in crops. And then here it is said that he supplies the seed to the sower. In these times, you don't need the seed, you need an investment.
No, no.
Need capital.
Imana izaguha igishoro kugira ngo umurongo wa 11 namwe muzatungishwa muri byose ngo mugire ubuntu bwose butuma Imana ihimbazwa.
Why you are enriched in everything for all liberality which causes thanksgiving through us to God.
Imana izaguha igishoro ngo ugire byinshi utange ibirenze ibyo watangaga ngo Imana nibwo izahimbazwa.
God will give you capital so that you might give more than what you are giving and that will give glory to God.
Ibi ni ijambo ry'Imana.
This is the word of God.
Ariko tugomba kubyiga.
But you have to learn this.
Ngiye amagambo ari mu Bakorinto ntarayagira mu buzima bwanjye ntacyabamfashaho.
You know the words that are written in Corinthians before I applied them in my life they are of no use to me.
Muri 90 nibwo narongoye.
In 1990 that's when I got married.
Ariko muri 89 twasengeraga ahantu mu mashyamba imvura ikagitunyagira.
But in 89 we were praying in the forest and rain will come down on us.
No, no. Kuko ari nge wari mwarimu sinari pastor.
Was a teacher, wasn't a pastor.
Ubwo ni nge wari umukire muri icyo cyaro.
So in that rural area I was the one who was rich.
Muri iyo myaka mwarimu na agronome na burugumesitiri nibo babaga bakomeye.
At that time the teacher, the agronomist and the mayor, the current mayor what it used to be before, they were the ones that were powerful back then.
Kuko burugumesitiri yabaga afite imodoka, agronome afite moto, mwarimu afite igare.
Because the mayor will have a car and the agronomist will have a motorbike and the other one will have a bicycle. The teacher.
Rero gutanga amabati y'urusengero ninge byarebaga nubwo ntari pastor.
So even though I wasn't a pastor but I was the one who had the responsibility to give the iron sheets for the church.
Rero amabati nari naguze ngo nubake ndongore Imana yambwiye kuyashyira ku rusengero.
Now the iron sheet I had bought to build my house so that I can get married, God told me to give it to the church.
Ubwo rero ntago nahagaritse ubukwe nararongoye ariko narongoreye muri geto.
So I didn't stop the wedding but I got married and I started living in a small house like a ghetto.
Papa yarafite ka ghetto mu gikari kiwe nuko ndongo.
So my dad had a ghetto there in his small house in his backyard so that's where I took my wife.
Ariko actually ngomba kuba ninge waronshinze ibyo kurongorera muri ghetto.
I think I'm the one who launched getting married and living in small houses. You know, when you walk with God, God gives you faith. You can even claim promises. So I had done my best, really. Now I wanted to learn everything pertaining to money.
So
it's a long story, but later on I got a house and in 97 I had to go to the Bible college, so I had to stop being a teacher. And at that time I had 3 children. I asked God, I have cattle and I have forests. So no problem with sweet potatoes, with vegetables. But where am I going to get sugar? My children were young, so they didn't know what I was up to. But God amazed me. He told me, you have cows, why don't you sell some cows and start trading some sugar? My wife has been selling that sugar for many years, like 15 years even after we came to Kigali. Now she has stopped doing that business because now she's more involved in church and we no longer need that money really. We have better conditions. It's true what I'm telling you. God has money and he gives that money.
Ariko hano baravuga ngo izagwiza ubutunzi kandi bizagenda byiyongera mutange cyane.
And he said he will make wealth abound and it will grow and you grow in giving.
No, minsi yashize twubaka nasare school ku rusengero ibyumba bine bikomeye ingero za UNESCO byemewe na leta kabisa.
In the last days we built the nursery school for rooms really on the standards of UNESCO and the government.
Gusa ngemba nshaka ngo nigishe ibintu ari ngiye wabigiriye experience.
Actually, I want to teach things that I have myself experienced.
No, ndavuga ngo ndashaka kubaka nursery school nta muzungu bigizemo uruhare mbivuga mu rusengero.
I said in church I want to build a nursery school and not with the sponsorship of the white people.
Ubu yaruzuye ayo mashuri yaruzuye.
Now that nursery school is complete.
Ariko urabyumva kugira ngo anuzure hari akazu nari mfite kandi katari yombamo nagombye kukagurisha nsukaho.
Actually, for it to be built, there is another small house I had, not the one I live in. I had to sell it so that I can contribute to building
Imana
that
igomba kuduha umugisha umurimo w'Imana wakenera amafaranga tukame batufite utuzu n'utundi tuntu tugurisha ngo umurimo w'Imana ukorwe.
God has to bless us, and whenever there are needs, we might have things to sell, like those small houses and other things, so that the work of God might be done. But it's okay.
Sometimes
we pay loans and it makes us sweat, but it's okay. It's no problem. You know, we are not going to default from paying the loans and no one is going to put us in jail just like the promise I received said. So what pleased me is that it worked.
Next step,
next step now is no longer those 25 millions of for the schools. Next step is other things and bigger things. The reason why I was so comfortable with the wedding preparations is because my daughter had brought me a budget of 6 million. That's how you get rest. You see God doing things, you see him working, and it becomes ingrained in you that he does that. And you know that whatever surprises you is not a surprise to God.
Yesu kuyarari no nukavuga kwari konu uri kandi kwa kuzahora iteka ryose.
And then you'll be able to boldly stand and say that Jesus is the same yesterday, today and forever.
Yesu yabwiye Nikodemo ikintu.
Jesus told Nicodemus something.
Yohani gatatu.
That is in John chapter 3.
Yaramubwiye ngo tuvuge ibyo tuzi n'ibyo twabonye.
He said we talk about what you know and what you have seen.
Imana irashaka kukwigisha.
God wants to teach you.
Urumva rero kuba umukire si ikibazo kivuko ni ikibazo cya spiritual life.
You know, becoming rich is not about your birthplace or conditions, it's about the journey in spiritual life.
No ubuzima bwo mu mwuka wahawe nago buzana imbabazi n'umwuka wera gusabuzana n'amafaranga.
The spiritual life you have received, it doesn't only bring mercy, forgiveness and the Holy Spirit, it also brings money. Money comes from heaven the same way as forgiveness and the Holy Spirit.
Usibye kwa amafaranga Imana igucira inzira y'ibyo ukora kuko cano yo kuyabona n'ugukora.
But for the money God will give you a path, things you're going to do, because that is the channel, work is the channel of getting money.
Gukora si umuvumo, gukora n'umugisha.
So working is not a curse, working is a blessing.
Niyo mpamvu ubukire bwawe ari igikorwa cy'umwuka mbere na mbere.
And that's why your wealth is a spiritual thing first of all.
Turashaka ko Imana yagura ubwami, turashaka kwidukoresha, turashaka
we want God to expand his kingdom, we want him to use us and we want to have money.
Ndababara yumunambwiye ngo nimutwerere nka muha 5 3 10 15 nago bimfasha.
I feel so bad when I have to contribute to the wedding and I give 3000 5000 10000 15. It doesn't edify me.
Ibimfasha n'ukumubwira ngo mbwire icyo nzakugurira mu byo ukeneye.
What I like is asking the person, tell me what you need that I can buy for you.
Amafaranga y'Imana nta limit agira.
Because the money God has is limitless.
Arakweduka ni nka plastic.
It's like elastic.
Nyifite umwana umwe muri kaminuza byari bingoye.
When I had one child at university, it was difficult for me.
Babaye babiri naho birangora.
When there were two, it was still difficult.
Ariko birakunda.
But it worked. I managed to go through.
Abana banjye bose batandatu bakiga byarakundaga.
All my 6 children, when they were studying, it was working.
Bakiga secondary bya naravuga ngo nibajya kaminuza nzahasiga gato.
When they were in secondary, I used to think when they go to university I'll be so stressed.
Hariko gishwara biroroshye nabonye ari kimwe.
But it's almost the same.
Umva.
Listen.
Yesu ntago yagucunguye ibyaha gusa.
Jesus didn't redeem me from sin only.
Yagucunguye n'ubukene.
He also redeemed you from poverty.
Yagucunguye imivumo.
He redeemed you from the curses.
Yesu anezezwa n'ukurya ugahaga.
And Jesus is pleased when you can eat to your fullness or satisfaction.
Yesu amaze kuzuka yasanze abantu ku nyanja.
After he was raised from the dead, he went to the sea and found their people.
Izo nkuru muzazisome muri Yohana.
You need to read those stories in the book of John.
Ikibazo cya mbere yarababajije ngo bana banjye mufite ibyo kurya.
The first question he asked them was, children, do you have food to eat?
No, reba ubuzima bwa Yesu mu ntangiriro no mwiherezo.
Look at the life of Jesus from beginning to end.
Yesu yatangiye ministry atanga divayi mu bukwe bw'ikana nicyo gitangaza cya mbere yakoze.
The first miracle Jesus did in his ministry was turning the water into wine in the wedding in Cana.
Igitangaza cya nyuma yakoze mbere yo gusubira mu ijuru ni ukubaha amafi yokeje n'imitsima. Nuko babivuga ngo arabibaha ngo yari yabyiyokereje ngira ngo umuriro sinza aho yagukuye.
The last one he did was he gave to his disciples grilled fish and bread. I don't know where he got the fire from, but that's the last thing he did before going back.
Bibiliya itangira ivuga izahabu igasoza ivuga izahabu.
When the Bible starts, it starts talking about gold and it ends with gold.
Yesu yatangiye atanga icyo kunywa asoza atanga icyo kurya.
Jesus started by giving drink and he ended giving food.
Ubwo rero ntago niriwe mvuga amakote n'inkweto ibi byose bikubiyemo.
So I won't talk about the suits and the shoes and everything, it's all in that.
Umurongo umwe nganisha kugusoza.
One verse as we move to the end.
Bice 8 umurongo wa 9 aho mu Bakorinto ba 2.
Corinthians, 2 Corinthians chapter 8. Verse 8, chapter 9.
No, chapter 8, verse 9.
Chapter 8, verse 9, 2 Corinthians.
Kuko muzi ubuntu bw'umwami wacu Yesu Kristo ko yari umutunzi maze agahinduka umukene ku bwanyu kugira ngo ubukene bwe bubatungishe.
It says, for you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that through his poverty you might become rich.
Ibintu byose Yesu yaduhaye yarabipfiriye.
You know, everything that Jesus gave us, he died for it.
Kugira ngo weho ukire ibyaha yahindutse icyaha.
For you to be set free from a sin, he had to become sin.
Kugira ngo ukire indwara yarakubiswe umubiri we warawushwanyaguza.
For you to be healthy, to be healed of your sicknesses, his body has to be crushed and bruised.
Kugira ngo uve mu bukene yabaye umukene.
For you to come out of poverty, he had to become poor.
Yavukiye mu kirugu yatiye.
He was born in a borrowed stable.
Bamuhambye mu mva batiye.
And he was buried in a borrowed grave.
Yagiye ku cyana cy'indogobe yatiye.
And he rode on a borrowed donkey.
Yatanze igaburo mu cyumba cyo hejuru yatiye.
He had to give holy communion in the upper room that he had borrowed to.
Umuntu utira muri karitsiye ntago tumukunda.
You know, we don't like someone who keeps borrowing in our neighborhood.
Nuko bamufatira n'umusoro.
And they had to stop him for him to pay the tax.
Kandi yararaga Getsemani mu gashyamba yatiraga.
And he will sleep in Getsemani in a forest that was borrowed. Do you think that it was Joseph, his father, who had planted that forest?
Agiye gupfa nyina yamuragije mwene wabo ngo amumurebere.
And before he died, he had to give one of his brothers to his mother's care.
Yari yaravuze ngo inyoni nimbwebwe zimurusha ubukire kuko zo zifite iminyobo ngo we ntabyo afite.
He had said that the birds have nests and the fox have their holes and he doesn't have any of that.
Mu Bafilipi baza kubisobanura ngo yari yarabisize mu ijuru asiga ubwiza bwe ngo azaducungure.
And in Philippians they explained that they said that he left all his glory in heaven and all his riches so that he might come to redeem us.
Yesu yarapfuye ngo babarirwe nta mpamvu yuko uburi imbabazi.
So Jesus died for your forgiveness. There is no reason why you shouldn't be forgiven.
Yarapfuye ngo uhabwe umwuka wera nta mpamvu yuko uburi umwuka wera.
He died so that you can have the Holy Spirit. There is no reason for you for not having the Holy Spirit.
Ibyo rero uravuga ngo ni iby'umwuka. Komeza urutonde. Yarapfuye ngo ube umukire nta mpamvu yuko urya ibiryo bidafite uburisho.
You might say that he died for you to get to receive forgiveness. There is no way you shouldn't eat food that is not balanced.
Kuko ayo mafaranga aranakenewe mbere na mbere ngo ubwami bw'Imana bwaguke.
Because that money is needed for the kingdom of God to expand.
Kandi wowe ufite kwizera ufasha abadafite kwizera abakene bazahoraho iteka.
And you have faith, you need to help those who don't have things because the poor people will always be.
Ikinejeje nuko ibyo nizera Yesu yabipfiriye.
And what I love is that what I believe in, Jesus died for that.
Ntabwo ari ukujya kubyandikira inzandiko ngo ubisabe kwa meya.
It is not for you to go and send application letters to the mayor.
Uwo mucyo rero ni uhenda kuwubona ngo ibyo ubimenye bikujyemo uvuge ngo uwiteka n'umwungeri wanjye sinzakena ukundi.
That light is what you're lacking, to have it inside of you and saying the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not lack.
Ariko njye mbwira abakirutse usengana ni njye w'inkinnyi mwaba mugize n'akago.
I like to tell the Christians in my church that if I was poor you have trouble.
Nenze ko ari njye ko ndi mu bingenzi bayatanga muri urwo rusengero.
Because I'm one of those who are the main contributors in that church. It means that God needs me. So I'm not going anywhere. Praise be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. No, you can't exhaust it all. You can't say it all. But as we conclude, I would like you to keep this. Money is a ministry.
Ubwami bw'Imana burayakeneye.
And the kingdom of God needs money.
Yesu yaciyeho, Paul yaciyeho, niwe uriho muri iki gihe.
Jesus has left, Paul has left, you're the one who is alive in this
season. Kandi uracaho mu gihe gito.
And soon you also live.
Uzacaho warabwubatse cyangwa uzacaho urindorereza.
So when you leave, will you have built a kingdom or you have been a spectator?
Ukunda Imana cyangwa uza gusibanganya ibimenyetso gusa?
Do you love God or you come here just for a cover up?
Ariko indi nkuru nziza.
But there is another good news. Beloved, Jesus has that money.
Yesu arayafite.
Jesus has money.
Narabibonye rimwe mbibona kabiri mbibona gatatu ubyabaye ubuzima.
I saw it twice, I saw it three times, now it has become a life.
Ntago ndi umwe mu bakire bazwi muri Kigali, probably sinzanabawe.
I'm not one of the non-rich people, probably I'm not becoming one.
Nani modoka mfite?
I don't even have a car, by the way.
Ariko ibyo it doesn't matter. Icyo ngenzi.
It doesn't matter what I know.
Nuko iyo nyakeneye yazana.
Is that when I need money, he provides money.
Ubwo rero.
Therefore.
Ntago nshobora kubwira umwana wanjye ko ntayafite.
I can't tell my child that I don't have money.
Oya rwose bimeze neza.
No, I tell him that things are good.
Umugore wanjye arabyibushye yambara neza.
And my wife, she looks good and she's dressed properly.
Ubundi mfite ikibazo kinkomereye cyane kitwa ubwami bw'Imana.
The question, the matter that is on my heart is the kingdom of God. Because as you can see, I don't have so many years left. I'm going soon. Some of you I can see who are in the same category as I am. When we are washing our face, we don't know where to stop. Because we have bald heads.
Everywhere.
So those who are still young, please take it from there. And those who are old, let us be old nicely. Having money and serving God.
Hallelujah, murakoze.
Hallelujah, thank you.
Kaweranda kunyotewe wiruganze muri je unyigishe umindure unyiyobore weguri njye dose ngenze kushaka mukawera Kawera twibanire Kawera